star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home.
Again, ladies and gentlemen, that was Ava Cosgrove at the 2016 Northeast Auction. Please remember, if you're bidding at the May 2020 online only Barrett-Jackson Auction, you are participating in the world's greatest collector car auction. Good luck and good bidding.
Yeah, Craig, I vividly remember that morning when Ava was singing. She did a great job when she was singing through that. And by the way, I'm Rick DeBruhl, part of the Barrett-Jackson broadcast team. And of course, we've got the CEO of Barrett-Jackson, Craig Jackson. And you know, the great thing, we also saw some of the highlights of Barrett-Jackson through the years. But we really have to point out the significance of honoring our first responders right now.
Absolutely. This has been a long time tradition, but now all our healthcare workers, everybody on the front lines, even those stocking our grocery stores. So thank you, everyone. We will keep trying to carry on and keep the traditions of Barrett-Jackson until we can all get together. Some great moments there, but now on to some great cars that we're selling. Today, the activity has been very brisk on all the cars leading up today. We started off the first day with some great activity, but it's led into today when it really comes down to the end. And everybody's been waiting and posturing and waiting to hit those last few minutes. Remember, we have an anti-sniping tool, so don't wait too long. We're going to close out cars every 5 minutes.
In many ways, it's just like a real Barrett-Jackson auction when you're in the arena and people are waiting, trying to figure out how late should I jump in. You don't want to wait too long.
You don't. I get this all the time at the live auctions. Well, I waited to the end and I raised my hand at the last second. They didn't see me. Let me understand. There's 5,000 people in the room there and they didn't see it. If you want to bid on a car, same online. Get in there, start bidding, because don't wait for that last second, but stay engaged.
All right, let's talk about how this is working. So once again, the auction started last Friday, May 8th. We have two sets of cars, a group of cars that are going to close out today. We have 36 of those closing out today. Another group, the 200 series cars, which are going to close out tomorrow, starting at noon Pacific time. And then we've got, just like a regular Barrett-Jackson, Automobilia, which is going to start closing out on Sunday as well. So in many ways, it's just like a regular Barrett-Jackson auction, correct?
It is. The only thing that's missing is you, but you're at home. We're all doing this the best we can while we're all social distancing. We are trying to bring everything that has Barrett-Jackson into it, and that is our team of the consignment specialists. We're going to hear today from one of our automotive experts that have been doing their best while at home to vet the cars with us and put together a great docket of cars. In our preview, we talked about it is the diversity that is Barrett-Jackson, the docket we put together, and we're doing this while we're doing it all online like everybody else.
So starting at noon today, cars will start closing out one at a time every 5 minutes, and the very first car that's going to close is lot 100. It's a 2010 Dodge Challenger drag pack car, and that car has already met its reserve and is absolutely going to sell. So let's talk more about this car.
So it's a fan favorite. It also has had most of the bidding activity so far. It took off really quick, and it is a factory drag car. It has an 8.4 liter V10 Gen 2 Viper engine, a two-speed Power Glide automatic transmission, features a single seat. It's a factory, lightweight wheels, slicks. It's a real drag car.
Now, a lot of people have been contacting Barrett-Jackson and want to know a little bit more about it, and your team has been answering questions. But one of the things they really wanted to know was, what does it sound like? So we took a video. We can play it so people can hear what this engine sounds like.
Yep.
And the amazing thing, this is really a factory drag car. They only made 100 of them. It's about 1,000 pounds lighter than a regular Dodge Challenger. This is a beast.
It is. When we fired it up for the first time, Jeff called me and said, "This thing's an animal."
Well, the great thing is this animal is going to be the very first car selling, and it will sell, and the prices have been cranking up, so people better jump in if they're at all interested in this right now. All right, let's move on to our next car, which is another car. It's lot 102, which we know has already met its reserve, and in this case, it's a 1969 Camaro. It's a Z28.
It's a Z28. It's black, white stripes, so they made 20,000 plus of these in 1969. That's the year Donahue won Trans Am, and they built them so they could legally go out and race Trans Am. They're a really cool car. I always wanted one of these in high school. They're high winding, they're great cars. Of the first gen, this is the end of that era. This car retains its original trim tag, indicated it's a true Z28, an X77 style trim. Exterior rally stripes are unique to the Z28 model.
Yeah, the first gen really only lasted 3 years, 1969, the year that, of course, everybody won. So this has everything you could possibly ask for. And, you know, really the 1969 Camaro was really, especially with this engine, the 302 engine, was the perfect blend. It may not have had the most horsepower, but it was the perfect blend of horsepower, power, handling, and brakes. That's why it was such a good Trans Am racer in its day.
It was, and they won the championship.
Yeah, absolutely. And once again, this is lot 102. This car has already met its reserve, so this car will sell today. You want to go to the website, and you want to see which cars have already met the reserve, and those cars are absolutely going to sell. And there's even more, of course, that are possibly going to sell as well. Another one that's we're going to see hit the block today is lot 106. It's a 1952 GMC 101 pickup. Now, this one is interesting because of its Texaco theme.
Yes, and this has an inline six, three-speed manual transmission, fully restored in that vintage Texaco theme, chrome wheels, oak bed with chrome trim, wide white wall tires. It is the era that brings you back to the great times of the 50s.
And let's talk about the fact, and we've seen this so far just with the three cars that we presented, and we've got that 2010 Dodge Challenger, then we've got a 1969 Camaro, we just saw a pickup truck. You've built a docket for your online auction that in many ways is very similar to a real docket at a Barrett-Jackson auction. You've got the old, the new, the modern, the resto mods. Talk about that.
Yes, and that's why we sort of picked this group of cars behind us here, from numbers matching muscle cars to resto mods to hybrids. So we have a little bit of everything, and we split them up on the 2 days. Now tomorrow, the price of poker will go up as always. It's Super Saturday, but a great selection of cars today.
Yeah, and like I say, a number of which have already met their reserve, so it's great to look at those. All right, so we just saw a pickup truck from back in the 1950s. We're going to dial the clock forward again, go to 2011. In this case, it's a 2011 Camaro Indy Pace car. This car, everybody loves these things.
And it is a fan favorite. People have been voting for this car. So the 2011 is the 100th anniversary of Chevrolet. Chevrolet partnered with the Indy 500 to offer 500 matching Indy Pace car replicas. The color combination is similar to that that was used in the 1969 Camaro, which we just talked about one, but that was the year they were the Indy Pace car. This car has just 5,150 miles on it. And I always love these. So in 69, they called them Z11s because that was what was on the trim tag. That was the year Mario Andretti won. I used to own one of these. I actually sold it to Mr. Hendricks.
2011, of course, that was the year that Dan Weldon won the race. Remember, J.R. Hildebrand was leading, going into the very last lap, going into the last turn and hit the wall, and Dan Weldon just managed to squeak by and to win the race. So it was a pretty spectacular finish that year. Of course, 1911 was the very first Indy 500, 2011, the 100th anniversary, although not the 100th running, because
yep,
that didn't happen until 2016.
Yeah, we had a couple of years there during the war they didn't run it. And I was at the 100th running of it, so that was another great year. These are really cool cars, rare, limited production. I think these are going to be collector cars in the future.
Absolutely,
for sure.
Absolutely. All right, we're going to go from a modern car once again. We're going to go back into the pickup truck range. And this pickup truck is a 1950, and this one is a lot different because this one is a Mercury pickup truck. And I know you and Steve Davis got together to look at this, so let's take a look at the video.
So one of the hottest parts of the market has been, amazingly, pickup trucks.
So we're full screen.
Steve was teaching us pickup trucks years ago. Now this one's in stock configuration. It's a very rare truck. Steve, tell us a little bit more about it.
Absolutely, Craig. And as we have discussed many, many times in the world of Barrett-Jackson, trends are always important, but the pickup trend has been around long enough now that it's just a staple. It's no longer a trend. This particular truck has been left stock, which is becoming more and more unusual, Craig, as we know. Everybody's looking to resto-mod a truck, put a big V8 in it, trick them out. This one, very rare, Canadian version, M47 Mercury. People look at these trucks and go, Mercury, I had no idea Mercury built trucks. Well, actually, that's the way they did it in Canada. You look at something, you see the Mercury insignia, you know that thing's coming from up north. And when you talk about stock, one way to really get your feet wet opening the hood of a pickup truck, understanding if it's been modified or not, is take a peek under this bad boy, and what you're seeing is the original flathead. The 3-speed manual transmission, everything on this thing is pretty much the way, including the 6-volt electrical system that you would have got it back in the day. And all the features, Craig, if you look around this bad boy, are pretty much the way it was when it was born. Beautiful truck, great opportunity to buy something that's really, really going to increase in value, especially because of the fact it is stock, especially when they're...
All right, Craig, you see a lot of pickup trucks. How many Mercury pickup trucks do you see?
Very few, and also it's restored all back to stock. You see an awful lot of resto-modded trucks nowadays, but that was a pretty rare truck. They're built in Canada, still retains its flathead, so great piece of history. It restored exactly the way it came off the assembly line.
Always amazing to me to think about that, the fact that, you know, it's got a 102 horsepower motor, which back in 1950 seemed like an awful lot, but for a work truck, boy, it was all about the gearing, wasn't it?
It was, and that has the old 3 manual.
All right, let's move on. Once again, from 1950s, we're going to go into the modern era, another Camaro. In this case, it's a 2013 Camaro. This one is a ZL1 Custom. Let's talk about that.
Well, this car, we think we have a video on it here, is a highly modified factory ZL1. Another beautiful car for our online only auction. This beautiful 2013 Camaro ZL1. Now, this car was built for the 2017 SEMA show, and that's when the engine was upgraded on this. It did the suspension, the wheels, the tires. It has really had a lot of improvements done to the car. And if you've been to SEMA, the goal is how do we take everything to extreme? So this car has 600 horsepower to the rear wheels. It has a 6.2 liter engine under the hood. It's also got a very upgraded stereo system in it. It's really been tweaked. The car came as a black car, and then they added the silver and the red stripes, same as the interior. It has red leather with silver trim with black suede inserts in it. Beautiful car, everything's been massaged on it. All it needs is a new owner to take it out and have some fun. Register at Barrett-Jackson.com and bid on this car. From everyone at Barrett-Jackson, we want you to stay safe and take care. See you soon.
600 horsepower at the rear wheels. That is a beast of a car.
So they took a factory ZL1 and then supersized it on top of that. When Chevy brought back the ZL1, everybody thought, well, that was pretty cool. Then they took this car to the next level.
That's the great thing about SEMA cars. They're almost really concept cars that you can now buy. Because in the old days, concept cars disappeared. But SEMA cars end up in, a lot of times we see them at Barrett-Jackson.
Absolutely. Beautiful car. Be a lot of fun to take out and drive.
All right, once again, because we've got such an eclectic collection of cars, let's talk about the next car, which is a 1965 Sunbeam Tiger. And once again, it's that perfect combination of having that British chassis with an American engine underneath.
Yes, Carroll Shelby had his hands in these.
Yeah, this has got a Ford V8. Nearly as similar to the old ACA, so the same basic concept. You know, Roots had asked Shelby to get involved and really perform the same trick. Biggest engine they could get in, of course, was the 260. Couldn't squeeze any more. Carroll Shelby ultimately kind of disconnected from the program, although he did get a royalty from every one of these cars sold. And, you know, we've seen so many of these. You could also get a Sunbeam Alpine, which, of course, was the four-cylinder version of this. But this was the Tiger, the beast, that had the big engine underneath. And a you ever watched Get Smart, right?
Absolutely. So this is what he drove. And these are fun cars. I've vintage raced against these, and they're pretty quick. And these were the predecessors to the Cobra. This is where Carroll got that idea and then took it to a different manufacturer, stuffed 289, and then ultimately the 427 in it. So great car, great color combination. So keep bidding on it.
And we've seen these cars in particular, I think over the last couple of years, really start to kind of catch on. They've always had a following to a degree, but I think that following is beginning to grow.
I think with the internet and all the TV, people are realizing, well, that's a pretty cool car for the price compared to buying a Cobra or another European car. They're good values.
Absolutely. All right, we've seen some Gen 1 Camaros that are selling as part of the auction today, but we also have a Gen 2 Camaro from the very first year, 1970. In this case, it's lot number 127. It's a 1970 Z28. Let's talk more about this one.
So there is a few Z28 Camaros in this auction. So we have quite a few of them for their own reasons, but we have our automotive experts, and we asked Jerry McNeish. Now, Jerry is the authority on Camaros to talk about this specific Camaro. And we have three of them to choose from. What do you think is the most important thing? And I could ask, the paperwork, the physical condition, the provenance, I know it's an answer of all three and how they come together, but to me, what we try to convey at Barrett-Jackson is the purity of the car. It is what it is. So if they're all equal, what should someone be looking for?
To me, the most important thing when buying a Z28, especially a 1969, is the drivetrain. You can replace the sheet metal and restore it 1,000 times, but you only have the original drivetrain once. So when I tell clients who come to Barrett-Jackson to purchase a car, I basically tell them the most important thing is the engine. If the engine is original to the car, years later when you're done with it, you're going to have the greatest resale value with the car. As a matter of fact, last year, I invited a guest out to the auction, Mr. Rick Jones, and he is the crew chief for two NHRA Pro Stock teams, and he had never been to a Barrett-Jackson event. Well, I kind of showed him the ropes and everything, and he wound up going home with a very nice Daytona yellow 69 Z28, and he was smiling from ear to ear. But like I told Rick, I said, you just want to make sure that the engine is original to the car, and that's basically what we look for when we're looking, especially if the card says numbers matching. We put it up on the rack, as you know, and we look at the engine, we pull the alternator off and make sure the engine pad is authentic, and then we'll look at the transmission and the rear axle just to make sure that it is the real deal. But I always tell people, whether it's on, you know, working on campus at Barrett-Jackson or even through my own company, is they made 20,000 of these cars in 1969. So there's still a lot of them out there with their original drivetrain or engine. So I always tell people, just try and find one with the original engine.
And it's really important to point out the fact that you know, you've got these experts who look at these cars, even in the online auction.
Yeah, so we're doing it virtually. Now, some of the cars, we had the experts go out and look at if they were in their region. Jason Billups went and looked at one of the other Boss 429s. Jerry had looked at the first Camaro we talked about when it was in Scottsdale, but a lot of them were taking a ton of pictures. Our consignment team is working with, that's why we're answering a lot of questions too, because as those questions come in, we're asking the consigner more questions, but then we're also sending all those pictures back and forth with the experts so that they can help us answer the questions. So sure. That's what we have the experts for. We have a great staff at Barrett-Jackson in the automotive specialist, but you got to have those guys that really know every nut and bolt, and that's what our experts know.
Just like guys just like Jerry McNeish. One of my favorite lots is lot 135. This is both a combination, it's a hauler and a drag racer. reminds me of the one that Don Perdomo, the snake, sold a few years ago. Not quite as much history associated with this, but this is going to close today, and this is it's a fun story.
It is. So it's a 1965 Dodge C500 car hauler with a 1966 Plymouth Barracuda race car. This is one of the last lots ending today. It is very unique, and you can buy this combination of these two and go out and vintage race. There it is on the drag strip.
Yeah, great combination. It just looks like something off of a Hot Wheels card, so it's great to look at. All right,
they're sold as a pair, too. You're bidding on both of them as a pair.
Absolutely. All right, and that is going to be selling one of the cars. It's going to be selling, in fact, one of the last cars that is going to sell in today's auction. But, you know, we want to preview a little bit about what's going to happen tomorrow. And once again, we've talked about the great cars. We see four of them here that are going to sell tomorrow, pretty spectacular pieces of machinery. But you also have something really important that's going to happen tomorrow, which is the car that is going to be sold for charity that Richard Childress has donated. Let's talk about that.
So this is a very special time. So Richard Childress reached out to us and wanted to say, I've been watching what's happening with this whole crisis and the food lines, seeing the miles this morning on the news, a mile line long, four lanes wide in Dallas, waiting to go pick up food. So he wanted to help. And part of that is putting 100% of the charity, like we do at all our live auctions, we want to help too. So this is going to go to Feeding America and Samaritan's Purse. It's an amazing piece of racing history. This is a Dale Earnhardt Sr. race winning car. Dale Earnhardt Sr. did not finish worse than fourth in chassis number 22 in its first three appearances. There's no buy fee. You're going to write the check 100% to these two great charities, and let's hear about them right now.
This is chassis 22. He won Rockingham the first race in 96. First three races, of course, it did was fourth. It's one of my favorite ones. I know how much Dale liked this car. He liked driving it. It is really a piece, so gotta have some bids.
Going to be there at the Vineyard. You might as well at least get a full case of Childress wine. You're going to get photo opportunities with Richard Childress. So once again, yes, you're buying a great car, because I mean, how often can you buy a Dale Earnhardt winning car, but you're supporting a great cause as well?
Absolutely. And it's a great opportunity, because Richard Childress has never sold one of Dale Sr.'s cars out of his personal collection. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, plus with the add-ons, and you're getting an opportunity to buy a piece of racing history, have lunch at his vineyard, and help two great charities. So please, keep bidding. The charity car add-ons have been something that he really feels strongly about, throwing these in to help He wants to help. We want to help. I think we all want to help. These food banks, seeing these lines is just terrific. This is a great cause. So please, dig deep, help bid on the car. That will be our first car tomorrow morning when we come on. We will sell that.
All right, so once again, we thank you for watching. Don't forget, cars start closing out at noon today. They're going to close every 5 minutes. Be careful. You can't just jump in at the last second and snipe it. If someone comes in with the last bid, the bid will then stay open for another 2 minutes, so it gives you an opportunity. But like with the real auction, you want to get in early and bid, get your number out there, and make sure you do it. And of course, we're going to be back here again tomorrow at 11:30 a.m. Pacific time, talk about what happened today, and more importantly, preview the spectacular cars that we're going to be seeing up on the auction block tomorrow.
Absolutely. Thank you for tuning in. Bid on your cars. We also have a whole team at the office to answer your questions today. So please, if you're interested in cars, get engaged right now for the cars today, the cars tomorrow, the automobilia on Sunday. This will give you a little bit of your Barrett-Jackson fix. Stay safe, stay healthy. See you tomorrow.